I have been waiting for this stream since Saturday morning. Shall I tell you what I've done in the time between the package arriving and this stream? I saw Eternals. I had a burrito. I streamed Minecraft. I've worked 2 days. I got all 7 Chaos Emeralds for Tails, Ray, and 6 out of 7 Chaos Emeralds for Mighty in Sonic Mania. And yeah, finally.
FBI, open up!
Oh god, the FBI are onto me. I'm getting the Chaos Emeralds too quickly. Finally, I can unbox this thing. So let's take a look. Hello. Oh, perfect. They're lined up almost exactly where I wanted them to be. There's a reason why we've got these two guys here. We've got last week's entry, X-Transbots Aegis, aka Trailbreaker. I'm going to move that out of the way. I don't need that anymore now. Okay, so we've got this guy. And then we have Grapple with Bumblebee just riding that shaft. That long shaft with the hook on the end. You know, that's how shafts are. Little hook on the end. That's how you hook people in. Welcome, Cine. Welcome, Will. Iceberg Synth. Where is Robopog? That's got to be done. That's got to be done. I've yet to have that. I did think I kind of need a Pog emote. I mean, the other, what is my other tier one emote? It's where is it? That's my better Twitch TV. Where's my actual
jokes with Leo?
That's right. The other one is eye roll. That doesn't seem to get much use. So I don't know. What do you want me to do? Huh? What do you want me to say? Warisky, hello. Hootini. Thank you for the shout-outs, Will. You can chuck them about wherever they apply. I can see Bumblebee doing that, absolutely. I miss a few streams and the sound effects go mental. I know, right? Yeah, Leo, that's for the Stone Philosopher Leo. He cracked a joke in chat, and I used my reverb to be like, jokes with Leo.
You unsavory little runt.
There's no need to be mean. There's no need to get like that, Will. Come on. Please. I'm just trying to make a living. Almost 4,000 Energon cubes, just 3,000 more. Nice. Alright, so yeah, we got these guys here. We're going to look at them more. They'll become more relevant once we get the figure out. So, this isn't just an unboxing. It's an S&M unboxing. Let me go and get the spandex. No, wait. If you're feeling agile, so is the box. If you're not feeling agile, don't worry. The box can be agile for you. Or maybe you've just got a lot of guile. Maybe you're feeling fragile. I don't know. I'm only 40 away from Sound Alert 5. Jesus, Warisky, how do you get them so quick? No way. Jesus, when was your last one? Your last one was, was it Jawa? Or was it, no, I think Will wanted the Tusken Raider. Jesus. Fucking hell. Unbelievable. Right, sorry, anyway. So, this has come to me from somebody that I bought Transformers off on Facebook. So, you know, quite chummy with them. And they run a shop on eBay, but it's also got a website. And he's enclosed, I believe, a 10% discount code exclusively for this stream, so I can plug his website. So I will be doing that, and I will show the code once I get out of the box. He said he's enclosed it. I lurk in almost every stream. I love a lurker. I always love those people who lurk in the background. You can't really see them, but you know they're there. They're just following you, you know, in the background. Without you knowing. There's nothing wrong with that, is there? That's totally fine. Totally normal behaviour. For the entirety, you legend. Currently feeling fragile. My entire face hurts. Oh no, Will, what happened? Is the other half beating you up again? What have you done this time or not done this time? Hang on, I've got to find the... So again, we know the rules. Cut towards the chat. Okay? So I've got to protect myself. But you guys are expendable. No, you're not expendable. Jesus, that's fucking horrible. I take that back. It's all Bants. It's all Bants. I don't want anything to happen to you guys. If anything, let's have a change attack. Let's cut towards me. That's right. That's safe, right? I can't wait to get my Transformers figure. I'm excited for you, Cine. Especially because you said it's your first one that you've ever got. Which, I find that hard to believe. If you've been a Transformers fan this long, have you not had one? Or is it like, have you only become a fan in like the past year or so? But even then. Infected tooth, and it's caused the right side of my face to swell up. Oh no, like a bee sting. Damn.
Oh, is man. The correct answer! Incredible
nice
knowledge!
Work.
Hello, Kinia. Welcome. Ooh, hello. Hello. Very nice. Oh, we got... that's interesting. The packing paper. Folded bubble wrap, that's fine. At least it's secure. I'm just gonna... There's that. But I'm gonna look for the discount code first, just in case it's loose in the box. I don't think it is. I think he must have put it in the bubble wrap. Yeah, okay. He did tell me that he included a discount code, so we'll see in a minute. Kinia, I'm very well, thank you. They drilled into the tooth this morning to drain it, but it still hurts constantly. Yeah, I bet it does. Jeez, that is no joke. Thank you for the shout-outs, everyone. Welcome, Space. Ah. All right. So. Wow. I can see the discount code. Very funny. Right, let's get the bubble wrap off. I really didn't have the chance to buy any figures before, but now I can. Oh, fantastic. There is no better feeling than a bot that arrives. Okay, here we go. Let's have a look at that in a minute.
I summoned you here for a purpose.
10% off. Primetime Toys. So go to primetimetoys.co.uk. Use the code WELCOME10 on your order and you will get 10% off. Okay? I can totally vouch for this guy. I've bought loads of Transformers off him, including this. So there you go. Go check it out. Oh, yeah, almost sponsored. I'm not getting paid for this. I literally just bought this. He contacted me to say, are you the same guy that you bought loads of figures off on Facebook? And I said, yeah. And I mentioned that I was doing a live stream. I said, oh, I'm going to have to wait until Tuesday before I can open it. And because I'm doing a live stream. And he said, oh, during your live stream, can you just plug the site and offer this discount code? So there we go. It feels very weird. It does feel like I'm semi-sponsored. But it's all right. We all have a good semi. Yeah. Welcome 10. So go and check out the website. I don't know what the shipping is like to EU or overseas beyond that. One use per household, discount applied to basket value. So hundreds of items in the UK in UK stock and ready to ship, including Takara, Fans Toys, X-Transbots, and many more. With no selling fees, the prices on our website are cheaper than our listings on other selling platforms. So there we go. If you're a Transformers fan, you check that out right now. I'll leave it here. Well, now it's kind of in the way, isn't it? If someone reminds me, I'll talk about it again periodically throughout the stream. Anyway, we have here today X-Transbots Paean, aka Masterpiece Hoist. Hoist. Like moist. Hoist the moist. He's the hoist with the moist. Ooh, it's open a little bit. I don't know if that's just packaging or if it's been opened to re-inspection. But there it is. Quote 780, Kinia said boobs, and I said PS2 booba. Not as pointed as PS1 booba, not as rounded as Unreal, no, UT5. I think I said Unreal Engine 5 booba. Possibly. Beauty! Absolutely. Abso-fucking-lutely. It's pretty much the same artwork as with Aegis. So what does this text say? It's easier to build strong bots than repair a broken army. There you go, that's his wise words of the day. Speaking of wise words of the day, the question of the day. Do you have a nightmare travel story? Hello, Leo. How you doing?
Jokes with Leo.
Okay. X-Transbots Paean. Let's open... It sounds like I'm saying peen, doesn't it? Let's just call him Hoist. Because that's who he is. Oh, that's tight. There we go. Okay. He's got all kinds of goodies. Just like Aegis did, does. We'll have a closer look at that in a minute. Let's get the actual bot out. So again, it's got this kind of fine sort of plastic sheeting over the figure itself. So let's whip that out. There we go. Oh, there we go. Not quite lined up in some places. Let's tidy that up a bit. Okay, yeah, that's pretty much good to go. There he is. There's his truck mode. And then we get these bits and bobs as well. Sorry, the lighting's not the best, is it? Let me... Is that better or worse? Eh. I've just created shadows everywhere now. How are we doing, everyone? I hope everyone's fine. And all well. Here is Hoist in his little robot mode. He's very back heavy. So instantly, I noticed that all I have to do is like tap him. And that front comes way up. But that was the same thing with Trailbreaker here, the back. Because there's a lot of die-cast metal. Like, there's die-cast knees. I think there's die-cast in the ankles as well. So it's very back-heavy here. So, yeah, there you go. Just a very slight tug. And the front just lifts way up. But there we go. So these are both by X-Transbots. And therefore, these guys actually share the same design cues. So the entire front section is almost the same. It's the same type of front truck there. The head is in the same place. The arms are in the same place. I mean, you can see there, they're pretty much identical. Except for the colour, which isn't really showing up that well. Hoist is a deep sort of green colour. And Trailbreaker is, I mean, he's kind of a dark grey, but he is meant to be like a black 4x4. Anyway, so one thing I've already know about Hoist that I can show off is that he's got this little section, which is on a little wheel here. It folds down like that. And these little pieces, they slide depending on the width of the wheels of other Transformers. So that's why Bumblebee's here. So I'm going to quickly transform Bumblebee. Cine, not really a horror one, but I was once visiting Tallinn, Estonia, and of course we were unlucky. A storm came that day, and since we sailed there, the ship was rocking. Oh my god. Having food in the restaurant was horrible because people were throwing up there, and when we got to Tallinn, we couldn't do much. Oh, no way. Kinney has got wine. Fantastic. You know what? I got 3 extra bottles of wine a few weeks ago. I need to crack them open and have a look at them. Have a taste. Maybe I'll have some wine on Friday with Spider-Man 2. That'll be funny. Getting sozzled with Spider-Man 2. Ooh, very, very ooh. Ooh. Alright there, Earth Song. Pizza time. The fucking J. Jonah Jameson video. Oh my god. That made me laugh so much. Pizza time. Oh, I can't even do it justice. Right, there we go. There's Bumblebee in his true form. Little VW Beetle. And then the front wheels sit in the little grooves.
I feel stronger now.
Like that. There you go. So it's like a little pickup truck. And you can wheel him away. There you go. How's that for attention to detail? In fact, Bumblebee is a little bit too narrow, but he does hook on there nicely, so he doesn't come off very easily. There we go. QEB, absolutely. So we do the same thing with, geez, is Trailbreakers, are they even? Oh, okay. Yeah, so maximum width is pretty much a Trailbreaker. Yeah, they don't quite. Oh shit, there you go. See, he rolled off just then. Jeez, he's too much of a brick. He doesn't want to work. So this is Grapple, who is pretty much Hoist's bestie. They share quite a few adventures together in the cartoon. So there's these guys next to each other. Very cool. So, I mean, they're both kind of serve the same purpose. I mean, you can even see the little design cues with the yellow and black striping. Yeah. There you go. Yep, there's my nightmare travel story. which was indeed a nightmare. All right, before we get into the accessories, another quick reminder. I'm not sponsored, but primetimetoys.co.uk, use code WELCOME10 to get 10% off. Code can be used once per household. I might even... I think I've ordered off there before. I'm not sure if it works for me. But I can always have a go. But for you, you can definitely get 10% off at primetimetoys.co.uk. Check it out. Astounding service all the time. Right, so for Hoist, we have this. An articulated grabby arm. Everybody wants an articulated grabby arm. What you're grabbing is your business. Okay, so it's kind of spring-loaded a little bit, like that. You can sort of see it springing back a little bit. But they are articulated fingers. There you go. Stick it out like that. The claw! It is new quote material, isn't it? Space, what are you doing? Oh, wait, no, Summertime Queen streaming. So he's having to get quotes between two different streams. So I think this just clips on the back here. Or it should, anyway. Looks like it's where it goes. Oh, fuck. Okay, note to self, be more careful. Okay, it's not going in the place where I thought it would, so I'll check the instructions in a minute. But basically, it's just that. That's what it does. It's like an extra extension grip thing. It's straight out of a cartoon. You don't see this kind of thing on the vehicle itself. I mean, look at the size of it. If you had this on a real truck this size, the whole thing would just keel over if it extended too far. So, that's that. But there's lots more. But we had the same thing with Trailbreaker. He had a lot of accessories. Oh, excuse me. So, first off, we have... some assembly acquired. So this is an accessory straight out of the cartoon, as that was. It's, it's some kind of energy thing. City, thank you so much for that host. Look at the size of that alert box. That's very big. Let me reduce the size of that. There we go. Make it a bit tidier. I didn't hear it. Summertime Queen is enslaving people in Fallout 3. Jesus. Of course she is. Of course she is. Why wouldn't she? But I can't remember what I've said, Space. So many things. You might have to go through the VOD and find it later. Oh, don't tell me. This is having this. I'm having the same problems with this as I did with Trailbreaker's accessories. The bags seem to reseal themselves. There we go. There's no getting away from that, is there? Oh, Jesus. Yeah, there you go. Thank God I don't keep these bags. There we go. One last little bit. There we go. So, I can't remember what this is called, but this is out of an episode where... I think it's actually Grapple who makes it. So, both of these guys are sort of like inventors among the Autobots. Kind of like Wheeljack. And these guys kind of took it a step further in Season 2. Because Grapple makes this thing with the help of the Constructicons. Optimus Prime says, no, don't build it. And then he builds it anyway. And then the Constructicons help. And so they're like, ha, we've built it. We're going to take it now and use it for nefarious purposes. Blah, blah, blah. Something like that. So this is literally one accessory from one episode of that one cartoon, that one season of that one cartoon. I mean, that's the thing about these collection items. They include items that have only ever been seen like once, maybe twice. There we go, that'll do. So it just kind of does that. It just sits there like that. It's like a little radar dish. I think the real thing is meant to be kind of quite big, much bigger. But they've obviously reduced it in size so that you can do stuff like this with it and, like, just pick it up or something. I don't know. Like, There you go. Pick it up, take it away.
Take it away. So that's cool. And then in this baggie, we have more accessories and also, as per usual, the instructions and a little character card. There he is. Maintenance Paean. And there's his, there are his stats. Well, apparently... Oh, wait, no, it's the red one. So he is quite intelligent, very strong, very skillful. Not very fast, and he's a low rank. It's easier to build strong bots than repair a broken army, indeed. There's like a little bio on here as well, but it's very tiny text. We will not read that out. We're here for the robot, not for lore. Kinia's answer to the question of the day. I guess it would be my travel to Slovakia to my ex-girlfriend. 5 hours to Krakow from... Is it Krakow or Krakow? 5 hours, Jesus. 30 minutes to the bus station with a creepy taxi guy. Ugh. And then 10 hours to Slovakia bus station, and from there 2 hours to our home. It was a nightmare, and even worse when coming back because the bus was 3 hours late. Ah, it's a nightmare. See, there's two types of nightmare journeys. There are busy ones, and there are long ones. God forbid if you get both. I had both. My nightmare story is both. But geez, yeah, that does not sound fun. Does not sound fun at all. So again, this bag is sealed in like 10 different places. Add this sound effect. The usual method of giving sound. What? What do you mean, Roll Risky? What sound alert do you want? Are you going to DM it to me? I've got my Discord open. I can add it now. Right, so... Grapple also comes with... some tentacles. Space, are you watching? And again, I think these are meant to peg into the back here. Oh, okay. Yeah, they do kind of stick in there. So, literally, just little... queef? What? Tentacles, I said. There you go. Just on there. Super, super poseable. So, yeah. And again, this is a thing that you could do in the cartoon. All of that can pack up in this little orange section here, apparently. So, there we go. Oh, wait, you want queef as a sound alert? Oh, my God. Just a soft fart noise, isn't it? Anyway. So this is, again, something from one episode. There's an episode where the Autobots are cast as monsters in a movie. And, well, they're Transformers. They're big giant robots that are in disguise as vehicles. So, what kind of costumes do you give them? You give them a mask to make sure that nobody can make the can distinguish the difference between the Autobots and the monsters on the film. So there's one for Hoist, but he also comes with one for Trax, who is not here at the moment, but, well, I mean, he's in the cabinet. Yeah, so they're different sizes. So this one is the one for Trax, this is the one for Hoist. So, Sunstreaker, official masterpiece Sunstreaker, came with his mask. My DX9 Richtofen, aka Powerglide, came with his mask. And Trax didn't come with a mask, so that's why X-Transbots have supplied an extra one, specifically for that figure. So they're not even including accessories for this guy. They're including an accessory for a completely different figure who is also official, like not even third party like this guy. So that's mad. So I will save this mask and I'll put it on him later. We also have a bonus head. We all love some bonus head. This is the toy accurate version of his head, with yellow eyes and a kind of mouth plate grill. When I say toy version, I mean as he was released in the 1980s with the cartoon. This is a toy accurate version that I've got him wearing at the moment. So there's that. And then, in a similar vein to Trailbreaker, we have some additional, like, hand pieces. Because, like Trailbreaker, Hoist has a, one of his hands is a, like, a pistol, like a gun. Like a laser gun. So I'm just getting these extra pieces out, ready for that. There we go. So you see we've got two of these. And these fold the same way as Trailbreakers, so they fold up backwards like that to accommodate the transformation. Gotta buy them all, exactly. It left me with 69 cubes. Nice. Nice. Alright, sorry, Warisky, let's add your sound alert. What you got? Quote 712, but I've got a 9-inch cock. What the fuck? What is quote 711? Here we go. Right. We're pausing the music to listen to Warisky's sound alert, which is...
What is that thing?
What is that thing? Alright, fine. Let's quickly add this. Boing. I mean, it's going to be exclamation mark what, isn't it? That's what makes sense. What in the butt? Sound files... I can't see chat at the moment, so bear with me. What? I said, what? There we go. Right, that's in. And then let's quickly edit this. Here we go. That's been edited, and then add. Whoops, misspelt it. My elbow is taking the plastic with me. 3-minute user cooldown. What? Submit. Ready to use. Knock yourself out, kids. Oh.
What is that thing?
There you go. Do I gotta add the game and date? What do you mean, Will? No. Quote 711. I'm very small, I'm only 2 inches tall, but I've got a 9-inch cock. There we go, right. Games and data auto, yeah. Add quote, everyone loves bonus head. Thank you, Will, thank you. No, Will, that's fine. Any quote that Space Bunny misses, you can pick up. And he'll very much appreciate it. My instance has very little Mass Effect sound, so I thought that would have its uses. And it's best boy Garrus. Hey! Of course, I've heard of Garrus, but I don't know of Garrus, so that'll be something when I eventually play the games. So yeah, a whole bunch of accessories for this dude. That is a extra hand because there's a scene where he has a hammer for a hand, which I put an image of this up on my Twitter actually. !socials. To have a look at that. There isn't a plan. Indeed, there is no plan. There is only. Quotes. Right, so I'm gonna transform all of these guys just so they're ready for when we get this guy done, so. Because obviously we want to see the comparison with the robot modes as well. Let's start with Bumblebee. How are you all doing? How are our weeks going? Are we all well? Are we all fed and watered? I watched Star Trek. The original series, episode 5 earlier. It was quite good. Very, very over the top, but a lot of it was back then. It's the one where everybody's affected by, like, having low self-control and, like, amplified thoughts or whatever. So, like, people who are timid are even more timid. People who are arrogant are even more arrogant. People who are angry are more angry, blah, blah, blah. So it was wild. It was a wild time, but it was fun. You know, I am kind of enjoying it, and it even managed to make me laugh from time to time. There's Bumblebee. Kirk must have been wild. Oh, definitely. Forcing food in for antibiotics. Fun times. It's all right, Will. Don't force yourself. Well, I mean, do force yourself, but don't overdo it. So let's pull out. We're going to do grapple first. He's very creaky, so apologies for the ensuing sounds. Be right back. No problem, Kinia. Right, I'll tell you what. There's some insane engineering going on here. So it does that, obviously. But the whole thing comes off like that. And later on, all of this will bend. It's much the same as Masterpiece Inferno. So this is official Masterpiece Grapple, who's basically a retool of Masterpiece Inferno. So there's a lot of engineering magic in this thing, which disappears into his back. So we'll see that in a minute. I mean, I must have talked about this before when I did the collection stream all those weeks ago. Hey ho. That Bumblebee's shadow right there. Small but big shadow. Right, let's pop this bit up. There we go. Put the head up like that. There he is. Yoo-hoo! I waggled his ladder parts. I did. And this bit goes in and out like that. Well, there's nothing weird about this. I'm just showing you how it extends. It bends as well, look. Ooh. I think it even bends. Yeah, it bends there as well. It bends in two places and it moves in and out. I said small bot, but okay, Space. I'll let you have that one. It's my fault for not being clear. I mean, you don't want to do this too fast, obviously. Because you'll damage the interior. You'll damage the joint. You might even break the hinge and then the end will fall off. You don't want to do that, do you? I'm sorry. Let's remember the real reason why we're here. Primetimetoys.co.uk. Welcome 10 to get 10% off. Anyway, back to the shaft. Let's rotate that bit around. So this is pretty cool. So this is obviously the mechanism that the back of the crane was attached to. You can split it in half, and it... Let's see if I can show this on camera. Let me move these out of the way. I'll tidy them up later. So this is how it is in truck mode. So this bit goes up and down like that. This bit comes down, and it closes up like that, and that will lay down along the back of his leg. And it tidies up really nicely. So let's see it from the opposite side. There we go. So that's pretty much one leg done, like that. So you can see how well that tidies up. Space, right. Quote 782. Oh, you edited it. All right, thanks. Quote 47. M from Owen. Jesus, that's only 4 months ago. We were less than 50 quotes in. And suddenly we're at over 700. It's insane. There we go. Let's just sort out this leg as well. Nice. So rock up the... bit. Let's move this aside and focus on the arms. There we go. So that bit rotates around and the arm comes out. Same on that side. We'll tidy this up in a minute. So again, all of this is going to go in there. Let's sort this out. So end pops out. Fold that down. Close it like that. Bend it there. Collapse that piston joint, and then the whole thing should just... Oh, wait, that's right, but there you go. So it's pretty much like that. You see how that collapsed in? Let's show that again. So you're bending this bit like that, and then this bit folds in and goes into the cavity in the back. And that's that done. Then it's just a case of tidying everything up. Although I don't think I can. I think that is as tidy as it's likely to get. Or is it? Yeah, no, that seems okay. The wheels help lock that bit into place. And we just fold that out. There we go. there is grapple. But we're not done. So grapple, much like Trailbreaker, much like Hoist, also actually has a arm cannon as opposed to another hand. So I actually have to... You have to fold his hand out to get the transformation to work properly, but you can otherwise put his hand back like that and flip out the cannon and then fold this piece of the arm back. So without even taking any extra pieces off, you can transform him and get that arm cannon out. Really great stuff. And there's his gun. I mean, you'd think, why would he need a gun when he's got an arm cannon? But this is more like a tool. Like a sort of built-in welder or something, you know? Now, is it the camera that's at an angle, or is it the transformer that's at an angle? I think it's the camera. Hang on, what if I collapse that? There we go, that's a bit better. So he's a bit of a chungus, but then again, so am I, so... He fits in well around here. And there's a cool little bit at the back that pegs his gun on there to keep it out of the way. There it is. Leo wants a dramatic reading of a song, Sugar, by System of a Down. Okay, Leo, I'll get it out of the way. We're here for Transformers, but okay. Right, there's Grapple. That is beautiful. Big old chunk. And there's little Bumblebee in front of him. Look at that. I mean, they look the same colour, but Bumblebee is more of a yellow. Grapple is more orange. Doesn't really show up. Oh, it does show up a little bit well. There he is. Right, so let's do this dramatic reading, and then we'll transform Trailbreaker, and then we'll do Hoist for the first time. So again, I feel like some of the cues from Hoist will be similar to Trailbreaker, but we'll find out more later. Anyway, first of
what
all...
What is that thing?
What is that thing? It's Grapple. What do you mean, Roroski? It's Grapple. Autobot Grapple. Inventor, designer, architect. He is an architect. He's an architect, that's right. There we go. So there we go. Right. I believe I have the reverb active. Excuse me, so... What do I need? Sugar by System of a Down. This is a dramatic reading for Leo. Okay. So... Reverb.
Activate.
Is it activated? Yes, it is. Good. Dramatic reading of Sugar by System of a Down for the stone philosopher Leo.
The kombucha mushroom people, sitting around all day, who can believe you? Who can believe you? Let your mother pray, sugar, sugar. I'm not there all the time, you know. Some people. Call it insane. Yeah, they call it insane. Sugar. You know that every time I try to go where I really want to be, it's already where I am, because I'm already there. The kombucha mushroom people, sitting around all day, who can believe you? Who can believe you? Let your mother pray, sugar. I got a gun the other day from Sako. It's cute, small, fits right in my pocket. Yeah, right in my pocket, sugar. My girl, you know, she lashes out at me sometimes, and I just fucking kick her, and then, ooh baby, she's okay. Fuck. Sugar. People are always chasing me down, trying to push my face to the ground, where all they do is suck out my motherfucking brains, my brains. Sugar. Chorus. Jesus. I sit in my desolate room, no lights, no music, just anger. I've killed everyone, I'm away forever, but I'm feeling better. How do I feel? What do I say? I forgot to pause the music. How do I feel? What do I say? Fuck you. It all goes away. And he says that over and over and over again. How do I feel? What do I say? In the end, it all goes away. 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 There is your dramatic reading, Leo. I hope that was to your satisfaction.
Reverb. Cease.
There we go. Sag, my internet is stuttering really bad today. I'll have to listen to it again on the VOD later. All right, no problem, no problem. All right, so I can move that aside again. So let's, again, quickly get Trailbreaker out of the way. So again, it took us, like, maybe less than an hour to figure out the transformation last week. And again, this is my weird flex. I can now do it without the instructions, and I can do it a hell of a lot quicker than I could in that first, after that first time as well. I mean, I know that these bits need to come out, but what is a bit difficult is, well, getting them to come out. They're clipped in like three different places. There we go. Let's move those out of the way. There we go. But once you've done one, the other one's easier to get out. That's what she said. There we go, like that. You can't really see, can you? Shall I get my... Yeah, I'll tell you what, hang on. Just gonna get something to fill in this background over here. Isn't it? Oh well, it could be worse. It could be worse. Anyway. Trailbreaker. Here we go. Split apart the back. Those bits, tap out the knees, fold these down even more, let's get the toes out, but not literally because no feet on Twitch. There we go. Ah! What's the problem now? Need a little tool for this bit. There we go. No harm done. Fold the heel round. One thing I did have trouble with is getting this, there's a little piece in the heel here, well, in the calf, which I had to get a tool out the first few times, but now I figured out how to get it out with just my fingers. There we go. Funky. This is just a synth pop playlist. Just I searched synth pop and this is what everything comes up with.
She's plenty able of murdering you herself.
Hello, it's Katie from the Sticks. Hello, Katie. How you doing? Welcome to Transformers Tuesday. This is not the new guy. This is the new guy. But I'm just getting these guys ready for comparison. How you doing, Katie? Welcome. How's your day going? Well, I hope. Everyone else doing all right, by the way? It's Tuesday already, and that means we're almost halfway through the week, which is a sort of like minor cause for celebration. There we go. There we go, and then I just need to fold the butt flap down.
I just enjoyed a cinnamon coffee. Ooh, cinnamon coffee. That sounds nice. Is that literally as simple as just having a coffee and then sprinkling some cinnamon on top? Or is it, like, specially made? Is it, like, one of those espresso machine things? That does sound lovely. Hang on, let's, pop out the... Oh, wait, no, pop out the wheels to the side. Then fold the arms down like this. Then the doors come out like that. Same on this side. Those bits roll, fold around. And this can just come all the way down like that. And tap in there. There we go. Boom. There's one more thing we need to do with Hoist before we transform him, but there he is. Cinny made a latte, made a milk creme, added cinnamon and syrup. Oh my god, that sounds amazing. Susie, hello! Welcome to Transformers Tuesday. Here's our new boy. We're just getting the comparisons ready for when we transform him. We've got Grapple, we've got Bumblebee, and we've got Trailbreaker, who was last week's guy. Just having a bit of trouble getting this bit through now. Let me try rotating his head around. There we go. What's next? I need to pop the wheels in. There. Thank you for the shoutouts, guys. Our amazing new boy, exactly.
My boy!
Sorry, I went a bit, what's his name? What's the name of the dead dude from Harry Potter? What's his father's name? Fuck. There we go. We're pretty much almost there. Let me sort out the back first. So these bits fold out. There's like these little tabs. You can't really see, but there's one there. And these bits fold down behind those.
Harry Potter is dead!
So many good boys, so many children. Indeed. I certainly hope that this is the only children I need to worry about. If you happen to be my offspring, please do us both a favour and don't get in touch. I think I would have heard by now if I had offspring. Right. So this bit can be a bit fiddly as well. It's just getting the back to peg into the sides here. Oh, I was trying to peg it in the wrong place. There we go. Boom. There we have a nice, tidy backpack. Which dead dude? There's quite a few. I've forgotten what I said. I've instantly forgotten what I said about dead dudes. Dead dude. Oh, right. Sorry, Harry Potter. Cedric Diggory. Amos Diggory. Right. Amos Diggory is the one who says, "That's my boy!" Which, I mean, it's a horribly sad moment, but, you know. His thumb came off and tried to put it back on. Hang on. Ah, come on. How you doing, Sithis? Welcome. Ah, there we go. Popped his thumb back into place. Nice little bit of easy surgery. Sorry, we're almost there. We're almost there. There we go. Right, finally, there is Trailbreaker. Sorry, we were delayed because we had a traumatic reading and then... Oh, jeez, anyway, right. So we've got Trailbreaker, we've got Grapple, we've got Bumblebee. ready for size comparison later. In the dark, obviously, because my lighting is shit. By the way, anyone who's just joined us, this isn't sponsored, but I was asked to plug the website, primetimetoys.co.uk. Here is a 10% discount code. Welcome10. Use that at the basket. Hang on, what does it say? Use once per household. Discount applied to basket value. So it's not just any particular figure. Just order what you want. Put the code in at the checkout and it'll take 10% off your order. So there you go. Really great guys. I've dealt with, I've ordered from these guys a lot, either through the website directly or through other sources, but it is all one business. They're really great. Really awesome fellas. He reached out and asked me to plug the site and give you all a 10% discount code. So there we go. I don't know about shipping costs to outside of the UK. Obviously, they're based in the UK. And as we know, this nation is repeatedly ass-fucking itself without a condom and without and going in dry as well. So no idea what shipping to other countries is going to be like. But you'll just have to check it out. But hopefully you can make use of this. 10% off at primetimetoys.co.uk. Enjoy. So before we get into the transformation, I'll do what I did with Trailbreaker and I'll get the Autobot badge on there first. Where are my stickers? I think that's them. Yes, here we go. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so let's try and use... I don't think a clear back one would work very well on there, so I'm going to go with the same as Trailbreaker and use one with a white back. Just need to find the bits that we were using last time. But I'll be in here somewhere. Ah, is that... Oh, okay, so these are the Toy Hacks ones. That's fine. They look the same once they're
Hootini!
On. Hootini! Wait, what? Ayo, chicken on a raft. Oyo, chicken on a raft. Exactly. Sorry, Susie's Nightmare Travel Stories. I've got a few. And one I'm not too keen on telling. No, that's alright. No, you don't have to tell us. Cine, I promise I cringe so bad when parents give these as toys to children as a starter collector. I wouldn't... Yeah, Cine, same. Like, look at all these little pieces that come with it. Look at that. And this, and these two bits, and you got the extra head there, and you got these. This wouldn't last 5 minutes in somebody who didn't know how to handle it. What does the box say? Is there like an age rating? Where is my box? Recommended for ages 15 years and up. There you go. 15 plus. Is this anyway. Might be less for others, might be more for some. Imagine if I accidentally put a Decepticon logo on an Autobot. I'd be so incensed. Right, so how big is Trailbreakers? Which one do I need to use? See, the ones at the bottom there are much bigger. But that one is smaller. I mean, really, I need that one, but I can't remember where I put the spares that are on that same sheet. Let me see if I can find them first. Yeah, those ones are clear. It must be somewhere nearby, because I... Well, maybe it was the last one. No, maybe they're in here and I just didn't see. Let's have another look. I'd like them to have matching Autobot symbols, if I can help it. No. What a pain. The only ones I've got that are the same size are clear back, and I need white back. I'm sure I didn't use them all. There must be some left. Space Bunny adding a quote. This wouldn't last 5 minutes with someone that'd know how to handle it. Thank you, Space. Oh, wait, is that it?
that's something else. Well, shit. I guess I'm going to have to put up with one of the larger sized ones. That's me right now, not being able to find this particular sticker.
Oh, wait.
They were in the desk that I'm sat at. For fuck's sake!
Whee!
Right, finally. So, yeah, it's one of those top two. There we go. See? I can imagine their cheese puffs, stinking, greasy fingers leaving marks on the precious boys. Yeah, on children. Yeah, children's greasy cheese puff stained fingers. Definitely not mine. You think cheese puffs have been anywhere near real cheese? Cheese is probably more true than you'd like. Yeah. Right, I need to cut it up. Okay, we're good. There we go. I'll leave a little bit on the end. There we go. So, I want you guys to remember how well behaved you were last week, okay? Rob offers wet wipes, hand sanitizer, water soap. No, I'm joking, obviously. But I definitely wouldn't exclude adults when it comes to having cheese puff stained fingers. I mean, we've all seen Toy Story Talk too, right? We saw the state of that guy's fingers. Right. You just remember how well behaved you were last week, please, okay? I don't want no funny business, alright? Cat jam. I think that's pretty much it. Let me just... Yeah, I think we're good. That didn't take nearly as long as the Trailbreaker one did, so... Now, well done, everyone. I want you to pat yourselves on the back. That was very good. I'm very proud of you. Thank you for not using loud, noisy sound alerts to disrupt this sticker placement. I'm just flattening it down with the back of this set of tweezers here. Just to get it all meeting the grooves, and then we peel off the top layer. Alright everyone, I'm Bono. Thank you for listening to our new album. I would say buy it, but I've just given it to you for free. Slight bit of interference there. Sorry everyone. Oh, no, come on. No, you need to stay flat. There we go. And again, it's incredible what a difference one little sticker can make. Look at that. Boom.
He's an Autobot now. It's payback for yesterday. Yeah, but at least Goku is easy to listen to. Yours was just volume. Do you have a nightmare travel story? No. All right, Raised. Jeez, lucky you. Timeout penalty box. For what? Oh my god, imagine if I had a command set up where anyone who used the sound alert Bono was timed out for 30 seconds. That'd be incredible. There we go. I'll be annoyed if I've... You know what? I think I've even got it the same...
What's cracking, little bitches?
...as Trailbreaker in the same spot. You see? They're kind of... almost in the same spot, aren't they? Which is great. Jazz is allowed. Timeout, Waroski. No, don't be so silly. All right, everyone. I'm Bono. Thank you for listening to our new album. I would say Boyish, but I've just given it to you for free. What a bunch of a-holes. Right, let's get these guys out of the way. So I've got more room to spread my wings, as in my bingo wings. Kinnear and Moroski timeout. I didn't use it for a long time. Indeed, indeed. Actually, those guys are casting shadows. Let's move them over there. Instructions! Once again...
What is that thing?
Once again, primetimetoys.co.uk, 10% discount on anything across the site. Apply it at the basket. Thank you, Space. Yeah, there you go. I'm not sponsored. I was simply asked to plug the site and show off this 10% discount code, so enjoy. It's one code per household. So check out the website and see what there is. Maybe you'd like to get into collecting, maybe you're already into collecting. Cine, Susie, Space. Everybody begins with S in the Transformers community. I noticed on Facebook, in the Facebook groups, there's a lot of people called Rob as well. Rob, Robert, Bob, Bobby, Robbie, Bob Boddett. S gang. And the gang symbol is that like spiky S that people drill. Right. Let's get in transformed. So, the front half I'm expecting to be very similar to... That's our Robert. I'm expecting the front half to be, what's up, Kinnear? What? Well, Kinnear collects as well, but you don't collect Transformers, or do you? Are you initiated as well? You could absolutely connect Transformers. One day... Right, you know what? We've had a crossover of Dracula, Star Wars, Marvel, Jurassic Park, Back to the Future, X-Men... I mean, sorry, I know there's a Marvel crossover, but you had, like, all the Avengers got Transformers at some point... why is everyone monkey-essing? I don't understand. What? When I say everyone, why is Cine monkey-essing? I collect Tomb Raider and other stuff. Exactly, yeah. I don't know if there's any Tomb Raider-related gear on primetimetoys.co.uk, but you can have a look and see what there is, Kinnear. Again, I don't know what shipping to the EU is like. Although, in my opinion, we are still in the EU. Or rather, I'd wish to be. Now I've eaten, I'm back to lurking and crossing the land of Skyrim and taking pretty screenshots. Miss Tessmacher! Killed him. Skyrim is good. I cannot wait to play Skyrim. Sorry, I'm still holding him like a lemon. I need to transform this guy. Towing gimmick separation. Towing function when square opened up. Those are certainly words. Towing other car, buy separately. Towing smaller car, buy separately. Hey! And the little diagram shows Bumblebee. Hey, that's what I did earlier. Yo, Rob, gimme $1,499.99. Why?
You fail me yet again, Starscream. Get them!
Split rear end of the truck. Lift the back side of the truck is literally what it says. lift it like a lady's skirt. Wait, what? No, don't do that. Not Cliff Jumper. I do have Cliff Jumper, but that is Bumblebee. You can tell, cause yeah. Although they did release a red version of Bumblebee, because that's all they ever did for Cliffjumper. Cliffjumper is love. I'll tell you what, Sinny. Transformers Prime, when Cliffjumper appeared, voiced by Dwayne Johnson. Maybe you knew that already, but for anyone else who didn't know, Dwayne Johnson voiced Cliffjumper. The Lost Valley statue of Lara costs that much. Jesus Christ. Every Autobot is love. Yep. Indeed. Lift back panel of truck. Yeah, I've done that. Pull up the section in red. So that's this bit. Yep, like that, I guess. Lift it like a lady's skirt. I'm quoting Pirates of the Caribbean, okay? I do not condone that kind of behaviour, but it is a line in Pirates of the Caribbean spoken with... what's his name? Mr. Gibbs. Favourite character, apart from that bit. But it's just what he says. Lift it like a lady's skirt. He might not necessarily mean in a non-consensual way. He might mean once you've consented to get frisky, lift it like a lady's skirt. You know? As picture shown position. Yeah, I've done that already. Pull out the red section. You're assuming non-consensual lifting. I was, Space. And that's why I corrected myself and said that it might not be that. Don't beat me to it. There we go. Right, so there's those bits lifted up. Mr. Gibbs is awesome, absolutely. Be right back again. No problem, Kinia. Red section, whole part, lift up like it. Special notice, part in red position when transformation, either robot or alt mode. Okay. What? Oh, right, okay, so it has to... I think it means these bits. These little orange tabs here, they kind of hook over... And they've kind of unhooked themselves as I lifted it up. So, okay. He's been in some other good if old TV shows. Yeah, he's in Johnny English. He plays the Prime Minister in Johnny English. RIP Link. Wait, what? What happened to me? What, the YouTube link is broken? Is that what you mean? Oh, no. Push the red part forward, so it just goes like that. Like that, okay. So far, so good. Susie sent a link, but it's removed. Link to what? Susie, what you done? Yeah, what was that? Rutroll. Then pull up this bit. I think it's wanting me to get the legs out, but... Oh, okay. Like that, I guess? Eh! It says, link is removed. And then your message is... Oh! Right, it's because Susie did Mr. Gibbs, but it says Mr. Dot Gibbs. So I guess it's kind of thinking that it's a link. I still see it as text. Right, okay. That's why. It thinks it's a link to Mr. Dot Gibbs. Yeah, exactly, Susie. And I suppose it's done it again there as well. Rip. Oh, no. Ooh, that doesn't look healthy. Or are they meant to flex like that? Okay. So it's... yeah. Right, let's just go to the next bit, next page. I don't see Link, it's only text. I can see it as well. Huh. Oh, maybe it's a mobile thing then, Cinny. Okay, here we go. That's a bit difficult. So this side panel, I know where this goes. This will be behind his arms, but you have to unpeg it and drag it down slightly on a double hinged joint. Just in there. Excuse me. Separate the shins. Yep. Nail up the red section, it says. Oh, good grief. I mean, I'd like to figure out how to extend the legs first. Ah, okay, like that. Okay. So we've got his pants. We've pulled his pants down. I'm not happy with my ratchet art at all. I want to restart. I explained this feeling to you, Susie. Ah. It's alright, Cinny. You know, you just got to come back to it later. I mean, don't throw it away, because you can use it for reference, but you can certainly start again. Just restart. Not happy with the paper quality, so it just makes it shitty. Have you got one of those, I don't know, is it USB or Bluetooth, like writing pads sort of things? Yeah, digital art, exactly, yeah. So... alright, okay, so you have to pop open the shin like that, and then it comes out like this. It's on like a sliding joint. That's interesting. I think I understand what's happening. Oh wait, does it have to go the other way? Ah, yes, okay. I pretty much just guessed all this, and it seems to have paid off. Yeah, it's just talking me through the things that I've just done. Alright. So, up, fold over. That bit collapses. Sorry, I can't really show you this bit, it's a bit fiddly. I think that's pretty much that. There's his legs. Look at that. He's got such chunky little legs. Jeez. But they're great. They are absolutely toy accurate. When I'm finished, we'll get an image up to show you what he's meant to look like in the cartoon. Yeah, that's pretty much done. Legs on my Optimus are tricky as they are on my Rumble. Is that your the little Optimus space, the one that I've got? Because yeah, those legs are... in fact, yeah, those legs kind of work similar to these. You have to like sort of rock it backwards to get it to fold over, yeah. knee pads like rollerblades. Yeah. Yeah. Is he wearing shorts? I guess kind of. I don't know what to make of that, but it's funny, isn't it? Right. Yep, again, it's literally telling me everything that I've already done with the feet. Rotate flat the feet. Heel in the right position, yep. It's amazing that he's able to stay stood up like that, but he's got these pieces at the back. You still can't really see them, can you? There you go, like that. I did the hip skirt as well. Right, and now it wants... I think the whole thing rotates like that, so I'll get that out of the way. And now I'm thinking that the rest of it will be like Trailbreaker, so I might just do this bit under my own steam. So... those bits come out. Yeah, you see? It's almost identical. Quote 179, the nipple suit, really? Clip in there, or is that clipped in there? Okay, that'll do. So there's his body coming together. Wheels tuck in just like Trailbreakers do. Funky beat, isn't it? The lower body section rotate, I've done that. Lift head up. Here we go. There we go, there's his head. Bit of a dork, there he is. Head in proper position. Yep, fine. Back kibble, pull down. Like this. Uh-huh. Bits with the back kibble is a bit interesting. So that bit's done. Yeah. Oh, it's got some bits built in here specifically designed to cover up some robot kibble. That's cool. And it just rotates out like that. It's like it's these bits, which you can't see because my fingers are in the way. This green panel here. There we go. Yep, good. Then he's got these little wings at the back. Rotate up the back missile launcher. That's that thing. lock and click in the kibble to back of the hip. Oh, like that, okay. Sorry, I'm still figuring out this this back part. Ah, okay. Oh, crikey. Sorry, bear with me. We're almost there. It's not particularly clear about where these pieces need to go. It's coming together well though. Yeah. It's a bit loose now. Cine, my knee space is so shitty. Fun to have long legs, right? They always keep shifting and tossing around while making art. Yeah, I know the feeling. Not with making art, but just anywhere else. Tall people problems. Definitely. Uh-oh, what's that? A pin. Where's that come from? That is a very small little pin. Can you see that? That. I don't know if 173 centimetres is tall. I have no point of reference for you. All I know is that I am about 6'1". No, it didn't come from there. Nothing's fallen off, so I'm not sure where this pin was. I will just have to find out some other time, I guess. Oops. He's proving to be quite difficult, this one. Things aren't holding in place the way it says it should. Right, if in doubt, start again. So, yeah, so it wants those bits down like that, yeah? 173 is 5'9". The chonk has woken. Milo! Milo, you legend. Good morning or afternoon or good evening. Both. All of them at once.
All of them at once, I suppose.
Yeah, I've already done those bits. Oh, wait. No, it's the other way. Oh, there we go. That was a healthy click. I don't think I pushed... So, here, it's on like a sliding joint, so his hips will come backwards for the vehicle mode, or this far forwards for the robot mode, and I didn't do them forward enough, so I think that might have been the problem that we were having earlier. So, let's try again. Except this is still a problem. Oh, they do come outwards. Maybe I have to leave them out like that. Oh, wait, hang on. There's a way I can get them. Let me get the arms out of the way. There's a way I can do it. Except now it doesn't want to bend, does it? Okay, yeah, they do bend. They're just a bit tight. Right, finally, we got him T-posing to assert his dominance. Okay, the wine killed me. I'm going to sleep. Have fun. See you next time. Oh, Kinia, no problem. I hope you enjoyed the wine. And may you have a pleasant evening and a restful sleep. Drink plenty of water. Okay, to help sober up. But yeah, have a comfortable evening. Ah, Susie and Cindy are only 3 centimeters difference in height. Wow. Yeah, I figured that was meant to tab in there. Aha, good. Interesting. Okay. So the those door windows, which were giving me jip earlier, they're sort of folding into a curious position in order to get this all to clip into place. So, oh fuck, and something's come off. I knew that was going to happen. Oh, is that where the pin came out? Right, okay. This pin that came out... Oh, Jesus, this is going to be a nightmare to get back in, isn't it? It's not even screwed in, so I can't easily take that out. Alright, let's see what I can do. Tweezers going to be enough for the job? I'm not even sure if my tweezers are good enough for this. Fuck! I'm trying to get this. Back into the robot. I suppose it's a worrying sign that this came out, but there's so many delicate parts on this. This is why you don't put it in the hands of a 5-year-old. Because it doesn't fare much better in the hands of a 29-year-old. Is it easier to get it in this side? I'm sure I heard something hit the floor, but I don't think it was anything on this guy. Starting to doubt if this is where the pin came from now. Oh, no, it definitely is. Yeah, okay. Ooh. Okay, good, good, good. I've only got them fucking put it back in. Fucking hell yeah. Now the problem is I've got no idea how I'm supposed to seal that. I guess I'm just gonna have to be careful. I am confusion. Other websites say that the figure I bought is 11 centimeters tall, and then other says 26 centimeters. Huh. The other is Voyager. Right. Okay. Oh, please don't fall to pieces this time. Oh, finally. The back kibble is in place. Jesus, how long did that take? There's a bit of back surgery involved. But now I just need to sort out his arms. And I need to quickly find out which of his arms has the gun on it. 1 second. Jeez, I've got a bleach. Hang on. G1. Hoist. It is his right arm. More often than not. Yeah, okay. Ugh. So this one. I'm gonna need to use a tool to get his hand out. There we go. There we go. A bit of tightness in getting that out, but I should be able to just slide off the hand. Yep. Oops, sorry. Need a hand? Huh? Huh? And now we're going to replace his hand with this. Space. Oh wait, no, no, I know what I need to do. Now I need to put it on. No. So he's throwing that Marge pose from that meme. Telling me I have to pop this out to. There we go. Let me just make sure I'm doing this right. push into the mushroom peg. Right, yeah, I am doing this right. It's just being a bit tight. There we go. Nailed it. After the third attempt. Thank you, Space Buddy, for the joke. Ba-dum-ts. Fucking finally. Okay, the next frig I'm going to buy is the Voyager one. They also send out a random one of those. Fantastic. Yeah, so to the uninitiated, in the basic... Sound like such a fucking snoot. So, standard Hasbro figures that you'll get on, like, toy shelves at your local supermarket or local toy store or whatever. They break down the sizing of the figures into names. So you've got deluxe figures, which are like your standard like soldier bot kind of height. You've got scout, typically, which are kind of shorter, maybe. Well, I mean, you see it with these guys. So I would say that Hoist, Grapple, and Trailbreaker are Voyager. Bumblebee is Scout. And then the other ones I don't have to hand at the moment. That is pretty much it. Yep, everything else is just showing how the accessories attach. But I did promise you the alien mask, didn't I? But let's just appreciate the robot mode for a bit. Here is Masterpiece Hoist, X-Transbots Paean. And it is a wonderful looking robot mode. After a little bit of trickiness, a little bit of fiddly, a little bit of repair work, which I don't know if I'm going to have to do again or not, he's done. And again, I don't know if that's the camera or Hoist. It's Hoist a little bit. There we go. There he is. Oh, look at that. That's perfect resolution. Look at that. Excellent. Thanks for mentioning that, Rob. Got to get the bigger figures. Oh, that's all right, Cindy. No, I was telling the audience. Oh, yeah, and then above Voyager, you get Leader Class, which you can kind of think is, oh, yeah, Optimus Prime, Megatron, etc. And then after that, you get into things like Commander Class. No. Is it Commander Class now? I always knew it to be Scout, Deluxe, Voyager, Leader, and then Titan Class. Your Titan Class being your Fort Max, your Metroplex, your Arc, you know. But here's Hoist. Autobot Hoist. Again, a sort of scientist, mechanic guy. Kind of in a similar vein to Wheeljack. Kraken Teeth Gaming. Got my Elden Ring Network test code for PS4. And it's downloading right now. Yeah, who else got their code? Not me! Sorry. No, I don't. Elden Ring is like a kind of Dark Souls thing, right? That's not my bag. But, Kraken, that sounds exciting. Are you going to stream it? You better be streaming it. Not that I'm able to tune in, because you always stream when I'm asleep, but that's no fault of your own. Ugh. So, Hoist. Let's put his mask on. There he is. Look at that. Wait. Oh, wait. No, come on. Come on. I'm going to need to get all of them, aren't I? Internet is working again. Oh, no. Cindy, what happened? Susie, what? I'm so sorry, guys. Cindy and Susie. Jesus. Shall I go and get the others? Let me know if you want me to get the others. So I've got Trax, who'll wear that. Sunstreak has got his own, but I need to go and find their boxes. That's the problem. Powerglide as well. So I can have four of them all wearing these kind of masks. That'd be funny, wouldn't it? Wow, what an interesting figure. It's really, like, you'd think that the legs look really stiff, don't they? You wouldn't think that there was a knee bend there, but there is. And it's on a nice, one of those soft ratchets that just... I can barely hear it. Cindy and Susie sounding off in Finnish, which I can't read. Not allowed to stream it, unfortunately. First test starts at 3 a.m. my time on Friday. So 3 a.m. your time. I don't know when that is for my time, Kraken, but I don't know. I'm either going to be at work or I'm going to be... Oh, well, no, if I'm working, that's fine. I can tune in. But it might be... I don't know. Somebody do the math. He has an ankle tilt. A very generous ankle tilt. Look at that. Damn. You know, when you just... You're just walking along and then... you stand on your ankle wrong. Fuck! And the wheels are on these, like, sort of slidey joints. And they do slide back down. So if you really wanted to, you can give him some rollerblades. Like that. They don't snap into place, unfortunately, so... Oh, no, actually, they're on a hinge. Hinge. So, there we go. He has a waist swivel. Not all the way. It's hindered by this bit on his back. But that's no problem, because that's still a good range of motion. The shoulders are a bit stiff, but they do have a ratchet up and down. He's got a single elbow joint. A wrist swivel. He's got an articulated thumb on two joints. His index finger is individual and the rest are on a fixed piece. These... Resplendence is raiding with a party of four. Thank you so much, Resplendence. Welcome to Transformers Tuesday with Masterpiece Hoist, who we have today. But, I mean, sorry, it's not really him. As you can see, it's an alien in a cunning disguise. But welcome, Raiders. Thank you so much. How are you doing? What were you playing? Oh, his ankle can also rock back and forth. Lego shark. Oh, yeah. This calls for a shark! Get out! There's a shark! Oh, wait. My face cam is... Oh, no. Oh, no. Right, I should be behind the Lego shark now if it happens again. Hey, guys. Just finished for the night. Hope you're having a good session. Hell yeah, we are! Have we got anyone there who can give a shout-out to Resplendence? Will? Or Space, if you're there? Kvick! Shout-out to Raiders! Thank you so much, Space. Playing Apex Legends! Are you winning, son? Were you winning? Will you win? All important questions. Okay. So the hip skirts can go up. And these bits come to the side as well. They're a bit stiff, but I think that's because they're working more than one joint. So that means he has... Look at that. Damn. Hoist be throwing shapes up in the dance floor. Hot Rod, is that you? There you go. Look at that. This is Hoist asserting his dominance. Look at that. Jesus. Have fun screaming like a Borderlands psycho with a shotgun. Yeah. Hell yeah. That sounds like awesome fun. Borderlands psychos are great. Itch. Oh god. Let's move him back up. There we go. Look. What is he doing? He's totally holding these poses. He's like literally doing the Michael Jackson like lean there, isn't he? Oh my god. Well, Resplendence, thank you so much for bringing your community over here. Raiders, my name is Rob. Or Robo Prime Games, if you will. I typically stream four nights a week, but I'm also a massive fan of Transformers. So today we've got a Transformers Tuesday, and I've been waiting to unbox this fella since Saturday. This is X-Transbots Paean, a.k.a. Masterpiece Hoist. And I'm not sponsored. I bought this figure from Primetime Toys, and you can get a 10% discount with the code WELCOME10. It's anything on the store, slap it in your basket, apply the code, 10% off wherever you buy. There's no information about shipping to outside of the UK, but you can always have a look and see what it is for you outside of the UK. Yeah, mostly aimed at Transformers, but there might be some other stuff on there that might interest you. Yeah, there you go. Check them out. They're awesome guys. I've been asked to plug their store, so yeah. It was a good lean, wasn't it? Sorry, we were looking at posability, weren't we? So we've seen the arms. You can angle this bit a little bit. Obviously, it just kind of comes and sits on top of his head after a little while. Or you can have it going backwards. I think it's probably canonically meant to be just behind his head like that. But it comes all the way down like that, obviously, for the transformation. So, yeah. Right, so I didn't really talk about the length of the vehicle mode. So Hoist's truck is longer than Trailbreaker, and yet Trailbreaker is taller. Just about taller, yeah. Yeah, okay, so there's the top of Trailbreaker's head, there's the top of Hoist's head. So, Hoist, longer in vehicle mode, Trailbreaker, taller in robot mode. But again, the reason I'm comparing these two is because they have... I mean, you can see in the shoulders that similar kind of moulding. And they have similar posability, and they've both got the same arm cannon as well. Although I think... No, they are actually the same. So yeah, there we go, Trailbreaker and Hoist. But Hoist is often seen with his best pal, Grapple. So let's show those guys together. There they are. So they're kind of a similar height. But in the show, I mean, not that animation accuracy was ever a thing in the show. I think Hoist was the shorter of the two. Or maybe it was the other way around. I'm not 100% sure. But there they are. And again, let me know if you want me to get all the alien bros out. And we'll have them all lined up with this face. There we go. Just out of curiosity, would that fit on... Oh my god, it does as well. It fits on Grapple perfectly. The hooking club. Yeah. I don't even know if Grapple ever wore it, but it's funny that it fits. Like, Grapple's head is almost the exact same width as Hoist's. What if I put the little one on Bumblebee? Let me see if this works. It does not work. His little horns get in the way. What about Trailbreaker? That one doesn't work. Yeah, Trailbreaker's head is too narrow for the big one, but too wide for the little one. So, yeah. No alien mask for Trailbreaker. Yeah, it's gone diagonal again, isn't it? There we go. Look at these handsome devils. They look so great together, don't they? Because again, they fill the same sort of, I don't know, category in the Autobot ranks. They're both alt modes that are designed to... I don't think they're construction... They're not construction vehicles. They're like rescue... Like, not... Like... What's the word? Like, What would you call, like, the AA or the RAC? What would you call that service? Repair? But, like, picking up somebody who's broken down. Retrieval? Rescue? Come on, Space, help me. You're good at stuff like this. I can't think of the word off the top of my head. I'll tell you something else. This. Recovery vehicles. Thank you, Space. That's it. Recovery vehicles. They're both recovery vehicles. You know. Especially because Hoist has that trail at the back to like carry the front wheels of a vehicle. And Grapple has the hook to lift them up. Yeah. But they advertise as fourth emergency service. I guess so. Yeah. I guess they're kind of emergency as well. Yeah. So yeah, that's... So like these guys partner up in vehicle mode as well as in robot mode. Which I think is really cool. And they're nice and different. I don't have many green Autobots. I think Springer, Hound, Rollbar. They're the only other green Autobots that I can think of right now that I have. In my collection at least. To tow robots that used to be able to fly in Series 1. Oh yeah! What's the name of the music? This is... Getting Nowhere, instrumental version by Americh. So that was... Hang on. Sparkle Cat, thank you for the lurk. So the artist was Amarich, and it was called Getting Nowhere, instrumental version. Came in with Rez. No problem, Sparkle. Thank you so much. I hope you're doing well, buddy. Sorry, yeah, I got sidetracked, didn't I? I was explaining to the Raiders who I am. Robo Prime Games, and I stream four nights a week. This was a Transformers Tuesday because I'm a big fan of Transformers. Mondays is Minecraft. It's probably too late now. They've probably all got home. Wednesday is Witcher at the moment, but it's whatever I feel like playing. Friday is Flashback Friday, and I'm currently doing Spider-Man 2 on the PS2. And Saturday is Saturday Scrolls for the Elder Scrolls games, and we're currently making our long, arduous way through Oblivion because I'm not playing it with fast travel. But it's awesome because I'm excited to see where we're going to be on New Year's Eve, by New Year's Eve, by the end of the year. Like, will I be about to start the Shivering Isles? Will I be, like, would I even finish the main quest by then? I don't know. Because at the moment, there are only 5 weeks of Elder Scrolls that I'll actually be playing. So, yeah. Right. So, this is a thing for every Transformers Tuesday now. We convert the Transformer to whatever other mode it is. So if it's packaged in vehicle mode, we'll go vehicle, robot, vehicle. If it's packaged in robot mode, we'll go robot, vehicle, robot. So he was packaged in truck mode. So let's try and put it back as it was before. So, and I'm going to try and do it again without the instructions. So we'll see how we do. I might need to refer to them a bit because I did struggle a bit more than I did with Trailbreaker. But I think by and large, whoever they are, it will largely be the same. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So that made sense. And that bit rotates around. Yep. Same on this side. Alright, internet is breaking. Catch you all later. Oh no, Cine! Fuck's sake! I'm sorry, Susie and Cine. God, can one of you change your names? Can one of you change your names? Alright, Susie, no problem. Please, I hope your internet gets better. Please don't judge me too harshly. I'm getting old, okay? Say nothing, people who are older than me. Because I know you suffer the same problem. Jesus. Right, oh, God, yeah, The arm cannon is really tight. And I've also got that face in the wrong way. So the good thing about flipping this out is that you can kind of use that to brace it, and that makes it easier to turn. But what I'm worried about that is that it will put pressure on that joint. There you go. So again, we get this nice and flush. And then let's collapse that and nope, we don't need to rotate it around. It's already in the right place. So then let's dismantle the back. So first off, unpeg that. And then we'll yank that out. Put those bits back. This is a song that takes me back to my early days of streaming. But back then, I didn't listen to the lyrics version. But now the lyric version, I fucking love it. It was my favourite song for a long time. I couldn't stop listening to it. There we go. Yeah, it's all coming back.
But it's all coming back to me.
Is it like that? That looks right. Okay. See, I'm starting to sing it now. Fuck. No, I'm gonna lift these bits back up because I'm not sure where they go yet. Put the head back down. it'll go. Come on. There we go. Head down. Head on! Transformers Headmasters. I think I can get away with putting the arms away now, so let's rotate these out. So again, that's very similar to Trailbreaker. Oh, fuck. Sliding the abdomen forward as well. There we go. Nope, a little bit more. Right, perfect. Wheels are sticking out at a funny angle. Why is that? Okay, no, it just hadn't snapped in place. All right, fine. Good. So what's next? I think I was doing the legs. Yeah, so the back is the last thing that goes in, so let's do the legs first. Rotate like that, yep. Hip skirts like that. Oh, I don't remember those folding out. I don't know if they're meant to do that or not. I will. Oh, wait, okay. Okay, I'm sort of semi-guessing with these knees. I think I know how they're meant to go. Oh, wait, hang on. Was it like... Oh, dear. Oh, wait, I didn't fold the heels back. Come on, out you come. Was it like that, was it? Ah. I think we're almost there, actually. Suddenly the back fell into place. Wish my back would do that. There we go. A little bit of trouble with the... There we go. Oh, fantastic. That's really cool. So this side panel that was behind the arm earlier, once we get it back into place along the side of the truck, let me just quickly do that. There we go. Right. So obviously the wheel goes there, but this was the hip skirt. There's a peg on this bit that pops in top of that arm panel. And that holds it into place. Somewhat, which is pretty cool. It's nice to have these extra ways of securing the alt mode. And I think these bits need to... Bit of trouble with the wheels, but maybe that'll solve itself once I've put this bit down. So first off, so these green bits need to fold under those orange flaps there we go, like that. Yeah. Look, we're so close to getting this done. So what's going on with this bit? Chonk is now having his breakfast. Ah, enjoy your breakfast, Myla. Feast well, little ham friend. Ah, they were meant to tab in front. Okay. Oh, fuck. Okay. Okay, yeah, so there's one bit I need to go and look at the instructions for, and it's the, how these knees are positioned, because I think these are giving resistance to this bit to stop this from laying flat along the track bit, truck bed, so let's have a look. Right, I was correct. Yeah, they are sort of folded in like that, or they're meant to be. Oh, finally, suddenly everything fits into place, and now that's all laying down securely along this bit. Fantastic. Bumblebee, is this Saturday? Words. Yes, Bumblebee is this coming Saturday. Movie mornings on the Discord. Please feel free to join! Discord if you're not in there already. Speak to myself or a triple changer, one of the mods in the Discord, and they can make you a movie minion. You can come along and watch some movies every morning on a Saturday, 10 a.m. UK time. And this coming Saturday, we are watching Bumblebee. Much excite. And that is, in fact, going to be the... Yeah, it's my... Fucking hell, it's my birthday a week tomorrow. So it'll be a nice start of my birthday week. If it starts on the Saturday, weirdly. Okay, here we go. Old man, I know, Space, I know. I will do a stream on the Saturday, obviously. Sorry, on the day of my birth. On the birthday. I'm going to live stream my birth. Wait, what? So I might do... I'm going to still do The Witcher. Just because I know there's not much time left. I want to try and get through that game as quickly as possible because I am enjoying the game, but I really want to play Horus, which is next up for the Wednesday games. Okay. Still got to work out a few kinks here and there, but then who doesn't? But there is Hoist back in his truck mode. With almost no referring to instructions. Literally just for one segment. And then there's... Oh, I haven't got another... There's the little Optimus Prime trailer. There we go. I love to watch movies with you guys. Ah, Cine, you're really cute. Yeah, Summertime does movie nights as well. So you got movie nights on a Sunday and movie mornings on a Saturday. There you go. You can bookend your weekend with movies with my Discord and Summertime Queen's Discord. Mmm. Alright. So I'm going to tidy up these leftovers, these accessories, and put them back in the box and just generally tidy up. It is almost 9 p.m. So we've been going for 2.5 hours. We're going to end. I'm going to see who we can raid out to. But again, one last time. I have not been sponsored for this, but I did order this figure from Primetime Toys. So please visit this site. Use this code to get 10% off your order. Primetimetoys.co.uk. 10% off with the code WELCOME10. Hundreds of items in the UK stock and ready to ship, including Takara, Fans Toys, X-Transbots, and many more. With no selling fees, the prices on our website are cheaper than our listings on other selling platforms. So, what are you waiting for? After this stream, go and check them out. Yes, Space, I was hoping that STQ would still be live because I wanted to raid out to her because I know that she often streams when I'm not streaming and vice versa. So let's go and see what she's doing in Fallout 3 in the Wasteland. I'm just moving some bots out of the way so I can grab my keyboard. So hang on. Trailbreaker, you stand there. Nah. Let's obviously finish with a look at Hoist. This is another really great robot. The only downsides are this whole section is a bit fiddly, a bit complicated. And we had that one pin that fell out earlier, but I was able to get it back in. Hopefully it stays. And there's a lot of accessories that I have to deal with, so they're the only drawbacks. But otherwise, fantastic figure. Like Trailbreaker, it's got a nice weight to it. It rolls really well. Look. And... really excellent gimmick on the back here with this, and the fact that you can slide it out to accommodate different robots for different displays. It's really cool. And it is on a little wheel as well. The wheel doesn't quite meet the ground, but obviously if you've got a robot on there, it will weigh down. So, yeah. Fantastic. Really excellent. Highly recommend. X-Transbots Paean, if you're interested in getting this yourself. But if you just search Masterpiece Hoist, you'll probably get this in the Google results anyway, because that's what it is. It is a masterpiece, and it is Hoist. So, let's... Ruh-roh! That aim, right? There we go. I'll have to change this back tomorrow. There I am. We'll do with this for now. So, let's go to Twitch. And let's make sure she isn't ending soon. There she is. Nope, she's very much still live. Naughty. She's instantly pickpocketing someone. Fantastic. Robbing everyone blind. Yeah, I bet she is. Is the movie Minions role just for fun? Because the titles are so cute. Everything's alliterative. Thank you, Space, for that link to Primetime and Toys. Yeah, everything's alliterative. So my streams are alliterative. Minecraft Monday, whatever Wednesday, Flashback Friday, Saturday Scrolls, Transformers Tuesday.
and I employed that into the Discord as well. So the roles became alliterative as well. Even the mods, triple changer, like ch-ch, you know. Although Cybertronians doesn't really work. But yeah, all the channels, all the topics, apart from the announcement topics, they're all alliterative. Really smart. Thank you. It's a struggle to alliterate sometimes. Right, we are raiding Summertime Queen. I'll get the raid messages out so you all have plenty of time to copy and paste what you want. There they are. We are going to go see Summertime Queen, who you may remember. You may remember her from such streams as It Takes Two, which was fantastic. It was really great fun playing that with her. And I also joined her recently on Heave Ho, which was hilarious. But today she's playing solo and she's doing Fallout 3. So let's go and see what she's doing. I will see you guys tomorrow for Witcher Wednesday. Please do come and join me at 6:30 till 10:30. Thank you for Transformer Tuesday. Cine, thank you for being here, as always. Thank you all so much for attending. Yeah, I don't know when my next Transformer is arriving. I've got a few pre-orders that need to settle, but hopefully they'll be due and they'll arrive in the next couple of months or weeks or so. We'll see. Anyway, Summertime Queen. Let's see what she's up to. Thank you all so much and see you tomorrow. Good night.
Back here when I actually have some science skill, I might just dump a load into Marketplace at night. I might just dump a load.